Hey everybody, so today we're going to be talking about something a little bit different today. We're not going to focus on a research paper, and we're going to be talking about video games. We're going to talk about AI related to video games, but in this instance, we're going to be looking at Sakana AI and Digital Red Queen, Adversarial Program Evolution in Core War with LLMs, and it's put out by MIT and Sakana AI. Off the top, overall, I should mention, like, to me, in the AI realm overall, the only AI company that I personally like, respect, look up to, etc., is Sakana AI. Like, I look up to Sakana AI above NVIDIA, above OpenAI, handily above OpenAI, Anthropic, etc. But just putting that out there, to me, it's they're the ones that are on the most cutting-edge research. And so the thing that Sakana AI focuses on the most, so like the their CEO is one of the Attention Is All You Need authors, Leon Jones. And then within that, and through that, they've had, like, their work has been LLM secondary, transformer secondary. They're very focused on, like, swarm algorithms, genetic algorithms, things like that. Like, that's their whole... play, like, there, I don't know, I haven't been to their website in a few years, but it used to be like Fish and all of that, right? And then so all of that is, like, very much associated with the identity to me of, like, Sakana AI overall, and that they think differently about these problems. Like, there's been a few research papers of Sakana AI's very specifically that, like, I've improved on them, right? Like, I've, like, their AI scientists, like, and things like that. I built out, like, a swarm-based AI scientist based off of their LLM model, right? So it's a company that I've been tracking and watching for a while, and I mentioned a few times, different times on this channel overall, right? And then so just mentioning that and highlighting that, to me, it's... there's convergence points when it comes to all of these things overall, right? The big thing to me, and it's like a big thing that, like, people would always say to me at the very beginning is, like, well, if, like, you're right about anything, then there's going to be more and more people, like, doing exactly like that. It will come out that way, right? And then, like, here we are. And then so this is just going to my, what I want to focus on here is, like, last year, or about a year and a half ago now, I created MOBA Swarm Agents. And so I thought this through, and then my framework is, like, nowhere near complete, mine is a, like, a far more philosophical framework compared to anything that Sakana is working on. So I'm not trying to, like, compare these two, just trying to say that, like, make it clear that, like, generally speaking, like, there's not a, like, I didn't just, like, figment out of my, like, poof that, like, this would be a good architecture, right? I, there's a lot of reasons why I, like, decided, like, I focused on this overall specifically, right? And like, if I had funding, like, if I had unlimited amounts of funding 3 years ago, this is exact, I would have built this out 3 years ago. Like, I was huge on this, right? This was kind of like my first big, like, moonshot idea with regards towards AI, that AI should be trained essentially, like, in, like, video game type of environments and systems. And then within that, that there should be, like, MOBA games that are designed and set up essentially to optimize AI agents. And then, I don't know, like, 3 years ago, maybe just, like, more people, like, thought that that was just a lot more fantasy and out there. And then, as you can see, that's exactly how this research goes, right? And that's, like, another thing that I want to point out within this and overall. It's like, and this is related to, like, anything when it comes to the top levels of, like, research, of companies, etc. Like, people always think that there's a further divide at the top of anything overall than there actually is. I can't stress that enough with regards towards anything overall, right? People that are researching at the top, that are, like, debating at the top, whatever it is that, like, you know, like, mechanic at the top, whatever it is that they're doing at life, right? They're still a person. They're still in the general IQ range of a general human being. They still operate and lead the general life of a person overall. They are wrong about opinions, etc. And then within that, I think a lot of people, they put too many of these things on a pedestal when it comes to those things, right? Like, and so researchers play MOBAs, right? And that's like, so to me, when I first started thinking about this, like there's a study that came out like from MIT actually a year ago. And then it's like, I have not met a singular person that has yet to disprove this, which they found that like every single person in their study, every single AI researcher has played MOBAs. And then like and is into MOBA games in general. And then to me, that's just a like that's a unique statistic within AI overall. Why does that exist? I don't know, right? But within that, what we have here is another company, independent, coming up with essentially this now like a same exact concept and idea with regards towards training AI agents in MOBAs, right? And then again, like, when you logic all of this out, you put all of it in, you put all these steps as to like how AI is learning, etc., all of these things, a MOBA environment tends to be a perfect environment for these things, as I was stating 2 years ago, and as MIT and Sakana AI are stating now. So hopefully now more people will take that concept seriously overall. I think they will. But so within this abstract and within the particular framework that Sakana AI has put out, they introduce, and it's another concept that I talk a lot about on this channel, but they call it a digital red queen. And then the digital red queen is essentially in charge of the evolution and optimization of the agents within this swarm system. And then, so again, if you've followed my papers and my videos, et cetera, for the last few years, this should be a similar concept and should be striking within you. And again, it's like there's convergence points within this, right? There's generally only so many like pieces to certain puzzle pieces that will fit. And then once you understand like the exact problem, like to me, it's just, okay, here's the problem. How do I engineer past that problem? And then how do I fix that? And that's exactly how I treat AI overall. And that's why I developed my Swarm Queen framework, was specifically running into swarm agents and then running into the exact same problems that they did. And then realizing that it doesn't work. Like, you need this in order to, like, this is the entirety of this framework, right? Because swarm algorithms overall, they have swarm algorithms are great and they're amazing and they're awesome, but they will converge immediately. I've talked about this before on this channel. It's been a long time since I talked about it, so I might as well talk about that concept overall and then just so people can understand what is going on within this. So this particular algorithm is utilizing swarm algorithms with plus LLM agents, which is a very common research area for Sakana AI. And then so within swarm agents, in general, what will happen is that swarm agents are very good, but they will early converge, meaning that they'll find essentially like a stable gradient within the latent space, but not the most stable gradient. So on any benchmark test, they'll score like 75 to 85% accuracy. And then you can't get anything to be able to get them to like increase that accuracy, because they're just always going to that same stable gradient. Like whatever the first stable gradient is that they find, that's what they hit, right? It's essentially what goes on within that. And then so you need within that then a brain inside of the swarm. In this instance, their digital red queen, my swarm queen, that is essentially that controls that, right? That's the controlling layer that essentially, like, when those agents get stuck, that something is optimizing differently, right? That has different logic overall than the swarm, and then is allowed to essentially like break free from those gradients. And then so within their game overall, they introduced this game called Core War, and they provide all of the code, all the GitHub repository for it, etc., right? And then within that, each individual swarm agent is a warrior, and a different type of warrior. And then so, and you can see it could be like an imp or a dwarf, and then it has a movesets associated with MOBAs, and then it has like each individual warrior has a different skill set associated with it. And the goal of Core War is like survival of the fittest. So one size fits all. And then they're essentially like, this is a evolution in a MOBA, in a box, right? That's exactly like, and why I like why this idea overall is a good idea, right? And why I've thought for a few years that this area should be researched with into, because it's accelerated evolution that you get to define the constraints for. Like, this is the best system overall that you could train models on. Like, if we had been training models in these types of systems for 2 years, we'd be a lot more advanced today than we were then, but no one was willing to invest in it then because they didn't understand it then. But so within it, and this, the one knock that I would say on Sakana's framework overall is, like, so to me, like, the difference between Sakana's framework and mine is that my framework actually incorporates the element of that they need to have friendly constraints as well, right? So Core War is cool overall. It does mimic evolution in that sense, right? Like, 100% survival of the fittest, but it doesn't mimic the friendly teamwork, other aspects of evolution that are counter to survival of the fittest, that are inherent to me within evolution and make up evolution overall and make up these systems overall. And then so within this, it's so that's my knock on it, right? Is that every swarm agent is an enemy of every swarm agent, but there should be teamwork involved and things like that. And I'm sure that they will, I'm sure that Core War will advance. And now that in the real, I'm happy overall that this is in the real world, that this exists. This is, again, exactly what I've wanted. And if I had the money 2 years ago for all of this, instead of just bootstrapping for the past 2 years, this is exactly what I would have invested in. This has been my dream to see exactly this come to life, right? This is one of the coolest areas and aspects of AI to me. Why do I research these things? Why do I dive into them? Because things like this exist, right? And things like this are actually really cool, and you're able to train AI models like this, right? I've always wanted to build a MOBA for AI models. Seems like a pretty cool thing to be able to do overall to me, and dive within that, right? And then so I'm glad that it's here. I can't wait to play around with this more. I hope that they evolve it beyond. To me, again, Core War next step is friendly elements, right? That's the secret sauce within it. How do these agents work together when they have conflicting goals? Because right now it's all the same goal, right? It's all one, survival of the fittest. Whoever survives, that's an easy goal to measure. But there's conflicting goals in life, conflicting goals in MOBAs, and then it will be super exciting to see how these agents evolve and deal with that overall. And now that that framework exists in a capacity where it's actually funded and backed and things like that, I think we'll see that. And so overall, I'll leave a link to the Sakana AI research paper here. If you want to check out the MOBA Swarm too, I'll leave a link to that too. And if you like this type of content, please like and subscribe. Thank you very much.